Nearly 40 years, the National Dance Institute in New York has given free lessons to New York public school students. And as Jeffrey Brown found out, these kids are learning some incredible steps. Take a look.
Fifth graders at Public School 2 in New York's Chinatown, learning to think on their feet. They're among 6,000 New York City school children who receive dance instruction each week at no cost, but according to their teacher, at great benefit.
They find a different form to express themselves. They find the self-confidence, and you really see them becoming their own person.
It's the work of the National Dance Institute, a nonprofit that's been sending instructional teams into public schools here for nearly 40 years. Filling a gap where school budgets fall short, filling a need, says Xuan Lin, where educational priorities are elsewhere.
In our school, and in any school right now, we're so focused on high-stakes testing, and kids do nothing but just reading math and reading math. They sit so much in my classroom, and this provides an opportunity for them to not really get away from learning, because they're still learning.
Ellen Weinstein is NDI's creative director and a longtime instructor.
The children learn grit and tenacity and to take chances and to learn that it's okay to make a mistake, because if they work hard and they commit to something, they're going to be successful.
Assistant Principal Joanna Cohen.
96% of our kids qualify for free or reduced price lunch, and many of our students are very recent immigrants to the United States. All I can say is there's not enough of it. Schools desperately, children desperately need more.
I always thought I would be either a doctor or an archaeologist or a crook, a really good crook.
The force behind all this is a legend in the world of dance, Jacques Dambois, who calls himself the New Yorker with the fancy French name. In fact, Dambois grew up in hard circumstances in 1930s and 40s New York. His mother started him in ballet at 7 as a way to keep him out of trouble. He left school at 15 to pursue dance full time, and at just age 17 became a principal dancer in the New York City Ballet.
If you think back, why are you doing what you're doing? It's those early influences, your teachers especially, and your parents. Yeah. That kind of write the scripts that you end up acting out the rest of your life.
Dambois would dance on stages around the world for decades. And in 1976, even while still with the New York City Ballet, he began going into public schools to offer free lessons to students.
I know how it transformed me, and I never paid a nickel or a dime for a lesson. I had free all the time.
The Institute grew into a citywide force with a headquarters in Harlem. There, every Saturday, children selected by their NDI instructors come for additional higher-level training, also free, in preparation for a year-end performance. Dambois still comes down to watch and offer a few pointers.
It's the best theater. It's better than Broadway to watch these fabulous New York City children. It sets my Saturdays off like having a birthday party.
The organization's been around long enough that former students like Dufton Garcia have themselves become instructors. Garcia was just 8 when he was selected to join NDI's Saturday program. He says his schoolmates didn't make it easy at first.
They totally made fun of me and they called me Twinkle Toes. And of course I quit because I couldn't handle the pressure. I thought, you know, that just wasn't for me, and I went into martial arts thinking maybe I can get my manhood back.
Distant memories now. Garcia found his way back to dance and uses laughter and his own experience to put children at ease.
You make it so that if the ones who don't feel like they're cool, you make it cool. If the ones who don't feel like they're maybe comfortable, you make them comfortable. If those that you feel like maybe it's just not for them, you make it so that they understand that it's for everyone.
11-year-old Jonathan Rosario had clearly decided dancing is for him.
I was watching and the teacher was saying, attitude, attitude, right? What does that mean to you, attitude?
Put more, like your own spice in it.
Your own what, spice? What does that mean?
Like your own movement. Like when you walk, you go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Jonathan's mother, Jessica Candelario, danced in school and says her son has gained friends and confidence from the program.
He talks about going to college, and mommy, I want to do this, dancing, I want to go for this. I'm like, do it.
Children will play till they drop, right? Ask them to put out the garbage. I'm too tired, mommy. I'm too tired. But if you say, can you put out the garbage walking backwards on one, and then hop on one leg, or singing the Star Spangled Banner, make play and testing part of the game, and people will kill themselves to be able to do it.
A glimmer in his eye, a lightness to his step, Dambois told us how dance almost killed him. Nearly every body part broken or replaced at one time or another.
What keeps you going now at nearly 81?
Well, breathing and a heartbeat. Hopefully.
From Harlem, New York, I'm Jeffrey Brown for the PBS NewsHour.